boys and girls. I thought I'd pop in a quick review here with the... It's a little short game called Tactics Ogre. You'd most likely finish it in an afternoon. Let's just boot this. I thought this game was an American. There's an American version. Hold on. I'm going to go re-get... Oh, shit. Huh. Well, I just looked it up, and I guess the American Tactic Ogre is called something else. I don't know. But this is just some out of control Japanese. It's like chess or something, but with a little RPG strategic twist, like kind of like Twister, but even more tangled up and mixed up. See, look at that—a freaking bag with arrows above. That's just the definition of raw wackiness. Look at this craziness. I mean, how is this board flying? That's freaking impossible. So anyway, that guy's like the leader, and these are his younger siblings. Not so. Man, there's a whole. I think this might be a tutorial. I might pause this. Well, puke around. I guess. I don't know how to get. out of this thing. It's like some. Oh, wait. What was it? Hold on. I think that was it. Actually, you like listen to 5 hours of lectures on how to move your cursor. Then you got at least another 30 hours on how to basic commands and such, so it's a pretty in-depth little game. I mean, it comes with like an encyclopedia, a whole encyclopedia series sized book on the basic fundamentals. You gotta order the advanced techniques if you really wanna play the game, if you wanna, you know, get past level 1, but this is just raw shenanigans. The shenanigans times 1,000, times 1,000,000, and that's a hell of a lot of shenanigans. So we're just gonna have to end this. I can't even play this. I'll give it a 0. But I mean, I'm sure when I get the American version, it'll get much higher. So just wait till then if you're a fan of the series. So yeah, I'll see you guys later.